Today we will discuss one of the very important topic, that is no detention policy. Here we will see what is the no detention policy first, then we will see what are the genesis of no detention policy, how this emerged, how it came, and then we will see what are the merits and what are the point on which the no detention policy is criticized, and then we will see that what we can do now in the no detention policy. These things we will be discussing in this class. So first, when we talk about the what is no detention policy, no detention policy says that up to the level of elementary class, that is class 1 to class 8, no student should be detained, means they should not be kept in one class for repeating, either the class 1, class 2, class 3 or up to the class 8. A student should not be detained in a class, and they will be compulsorily promoted to the next class at the end of academic year. So they are not supposed to repeat the class. That is the main statement of no detention policy. And after that, when the class 9 will come, then there will be an exam, and then if the student's achievement is not up to the mark, then they can be detained in class 9 or similarly in class 10, that is when they will fail to clear the pass the board examination, or similarly in class 11 and class 12. But up to the level of elementary school, up to the level of class 8, the student will not be detained in a class. That is the main statement of no detention policy. Then the point comes that from where it comes, what is the genesis of this no detention policy. Then first we have to understand the constitutional provision, that what is the constitutional change happened which promoted the no detention policy, the emerging of no detention policy. So in that, the first step is that 86th Constitutional Amendment Act, that is brought into the year 2002. In this constitutional amendment, a new article, Article 21A, is inserted. And that 20A article says that there is a fundamental right of every child of this country to get free and compulsory quality education for all the children between the age group of 6 to 14 year. They have a fundamental right. When we say that fundamental right, which means that no child will be denied from getting elementary education, and in the other word we can understand, it is a duty of state. A state means here the government, not a particular state like a Bihar, Jharkhand, UP, Orissa, Bengal, like that. No, in the political language, when we say state, it means the government. So it is a duty, binding duty, means binding duty means they cannot deny by providing a quality education to the children of the age group between the bracket 6 to 14 years. So the first thing is that the child have a fundamental right, and fundamental right means they cannot be denied. And the second thing is that it is the duty of government to provide elementary education. This was the one landmark when we talk about the no detention policy. NDP. The second thing is that consecutively after that, in 2009, one act is passed by the Parliament of India, that is Right of Children of Free and Compulsory Education, 2009, which is popularly known as the RTE Act 2009, which guarantees that the constitutional provision under the section under the Article 21A, which says that it is the fundamental right that will be guaranteed, because the constitutional amendment was done in the year 2002, but there is a necessity of taking a step to ensure that guarantee, that fundamental right. So in the 2009, that act was enacted by the Parliament of India, and subsequently the legislative assembly of the different state, they have notified the rules for RTE Act, because we know that education comes under the concurrent list. Otherwise, the RTE Act was sufficient to be implemented throughout the country, but since it comes under the concurrent list, that's why subsequently the state have also notified, which was effective from the 1st April 2010. So one thing is that it is a fundamental right. The other thing is that if we are saying a fundamental right and a quality education, these two things always remember. It is not only there that the government is bound to provide elementary education. No, they are bound to provide quality elementary education. And when we are saying that it is a fundamental right and they are bound to, then government must work on improving the enrollment rate so that all the students can come to the school, and reducing the dropout rate so that once they have come, they will not go outside the school unless or until completing the elementary. So there was a necessity to take steps. First step, to improve the enrollment rate. Second is to reduce the dropout rate. And then if we are saying that we have to improve the enrollment rate and reduce the dropout rate, then we have to also work on that what is causing in improvement of dropout rate, means why the students are going out of the school. And similarly, we have to also work that how we can improve the enrollment rate. Okay, so these are the background. Then the second background is that when you will find several research evidences, that research evidences identifies, indicates that detaining the student by a year or more than a year in a single class does not improve learning outcome significantly. Means suppose that one student is repeating in a class more than a year. Ideally, we should pass from one class, suppose that it is a class 6. So we should go from 6 to 7 in a one academic year. But for some reason, if a student is not able to perform up to that level to promote them into the next class, then they will be detained in class 6 to repeat. But research evidence says that detaining a student in a class for one or more than one a year in a class does not improve the learning outcome significantly. Achievement is not improved significantly. Even the another committee, one of the committee, which is known as the Geeta Bukkal Committee, which also admits the research finding and says that no, there is no significant improvement if we are detaining the student. And on the other side, when you will see, it is not improving, and on the other side, it is demotivating the student from coming to a school because they have to repeat the class, so they will be demotivated. Sometimes it is also an emotional issue because their classmates are promoted to the next class and they are supposed to repeat the class. And sometimes it is an issue of a social issue also. If the student is repeating in a class, then parent will think that they are not improving and they will take their children out of the school. So it is found out that it is not improving and it is demotivating, thus it is increasing the dropout rate. And if it will be increase the dropout rate, then the assurance and the universalization of elementary education will not be reached. We cannot assure their fundamental right. So it was seen as one of the cause of denying their fundamental right of education. Isn't it? That is the background. Then the needed no detention policy came. But what does the new detention policy says? What is its basic assumptions and a plan of action of a no detention policy? We have seen that providing quality elementary education is now a responsibility of a government. They cannot deny. And the detaining student, it demotivates and increases the dropout rates. Then the point comes that how we can implement that. We are not supposed to detain them. Then CCE, that is the continuous and comprehensive evaluation, was thought of as one of the tools to ensure a quality learning and no detention policy, supporting a no detention policy. It says that since we are not supposed to detain the student in a class, but we have to also ensure that minimum competency of that grade a child should develop. So there will be no pass and fail type of incident. However, the minimum level of attainment of learning outcome will be ensured by the CCE. And this says that at a frequent level, at a regular frequency, internal assessment will be done. And when we talk about the assessment, we know that assessment is a modality to understand learner's difficulty, learner strength. Side by side also, teacher also get reflection out of their teaching and they try to identify where the students are facing difficulty, and on time they are working on that to support the child. So the modality was that the learner will be continuously and comprehensively assessed and evaluated to ensure that they must attain the minimum learning outcome of that grade. Isn't it? Then another thing is that since in a detention policy, the education becomes exam oriented. Education becomes exam oriented, and teachers are working for making the student to pass the exam. That how we will prepare, how we will make a practice so that they will pass the exam. And in that way, The incident of rote learning has been identified. That whether the student are understanding or not, with but by practice, they will memorize those things and they will reproduce when the exam will come. So it was promoting the rote learning also. But in the no detention policy, the incident of rote learning will be minimized. Why? Because there is a no tension of passing and failing. So the student can concentrate over understanding the fact, understanding the concept, developing mastery over that. And teacher can also focus on the developing the mastery and making them understand rather than preparing them for the examination. Because once the incident of exam will come and once the incident of pass and fail will come, so a student will be judged also on the basis of their performance in the examination. Side by side, teacher will be also judged, because if the student will not perform better, then they will criticize the teacher also, that the teacher was not teaching well. So they become more oriented towards the exam. So it becomes a examination focused education system. And the no detention policy breaks those things to make it learning oriented education system. So that was the main assumption of no detention policy. Then another thing was that in the RTE Act also, it was said that the student should not be detained in the class, isn't it? So it was a legal implication also, because if you will detain the student in a class, then the legal action can be taken. So that was the legal aspect that we will not emphasize much here in this discussion. Then another logic was that when we talk about the no detention, then a student can come out of the unnecessary anxiety, exam phobia, exam tension at an early stage of their studentship. Because it has been observed that in the class 5, 6, 7, 8 also, they have a throat cut competition to fetch a 1-1 mark to come or to perform better than the other student. So it will reduce the unnecessary competition also. Then now we will see that we have seen that how the no detention policy came into the existence. Then we will see that what are the benefit of no detention policy. The first thing that which is very clearly seen over the country is that by implementation of no detention policy, first thing was that student enrollment increased. Why the student enrollment increased? There was a two aspect. One aspect was the constitutional provision, that it is now a provision in the constitution that you are supposed to provide a free and compulsory education. So that was the constitutional provision. Another was that students were not having fear of a failure, fear of a throat cut competition. So they were also motivated to come to the school. There was a sociological reason also. Suppose that the parents whose students, whose children are not very well in the study, they were not admitting them, enrolling them in the school, because they were thinking that if they will perform poor in the school, then their prestige will be reduced in the society. And I have seen some of the incident in my life that they have not enrolled their ward in the school because of the prestige issue. So that enrollment rate increased. And the second thing was that it has also decreased the dropout rate, because the student who were dropping out because of they are supposed to repeat the class, because of they were demotivated to continue this schooling, since they have not performed up to the mark. So all these things were scrapped, and which resulted in improvement in the enrollment rate and decrease in the dropout rate. And with these two things, means increase in the enrollment and decrease in the dropout rate, now the student were in the school for a longer period. And since they were in the longer period, so they have developed their skill more than that who were drop out from the school at an early stage. Suppose that some student drop out at class 4, but with the no detention policy, they have continued their education up to the class 8, which resulted in development of more skills, more knowledge, and thus they had a better opportunity to earn and a sustainable livelihood. Because if you have a more skill, if you have been more in the school for the more time, then it will increase the livelihood opportunity to earn, opportunity for a sustainable livelihood. And the again next important part of this no detention policy, the positive impact of a no detention policy, was that it increased to learn regional language and a vocational education. Because the no detention policy helps to bring in the focus on learning regional language and vocational skills. Periodic evaluation are conducted for a children with keen focus on their regional language as well as on the vocational skill development. That points that when these two things will be clubbed, then they will be better prepared for the some of the vocational skills programs that was promoted by the government. Because for a pursuing a vocational skill program also, there are requirement of minimal level of learning. So that's the it helped in bringing out the positive impact in the society. Even when we talk about the state like Maharashtra, Telangana and Karnataka, these three states supported the new no detention policy, and this says that implementing the no detention policy has reduced schooling dropout. Similarly, the Telangana says that it enables a child to learn better without a fear of failure. even the Karnataka says that it is important for sustainable development. However, it is not like that. The story is that much good, well and good. There was a constitutional support, there was an act and law, there was a success story too, but there was no something loose fault. Simultaneously, it has been observed widely that there is a serious issue with no detention policy. It is also observed the serious issue. And in this part, Kerala says that there is no harm in allowing a student one more year to recoup together with allowing the others to pass. Even the Haryana says that decrease commitment level of a stakeholder. It decreases the commitment level. Even the Delhi government says that result in unreasonable, undisciplined behavior of the student. It has come because they were not having a pressure of the academic learning. So their behavior, the behavioral problem was there. And even the Kerala says that since from class 1 to class 8, they don't have faced any examination. So when they come to a class 9 and suddenly they are exposed to examination, then they are under the traumatic pressure of examination. The examination pressure is too high because they are not prepared for that. So that was also one of the big issues. Even we have seen that examination will be not there, but there will be a continuous and comprehensive evaluation and assessment throughout the year, and the teacher will understand the difficulty of a student. They will also understand the merit of a student. They will also understand the strength of a student, and based upon that they will design their teaching learning process. But what happened? It has impacted on the quality of education, because we have assumed that these will be taken care with a CCE. But CCE was wrongly conceived by the teachers and even by the parents. And the main essence of a CCE was never implemented. It was supposed that examination will be not there, but that will be managed by the continuous support to the student. Or in a better word, I can say directly that it was a duty of a teacher and a system, not only the teacher, of a system to prepare the student for at least minimum level of attainment. In the mark, when we say, suppose that in an exam, the passing mark is a 40%. So when the no detention policy was designed, it was supposed that exam will be not there, but those minimum level of attainment will be assured by the teachers. And suppose that I was giving one example that 40% is a passing mark. Means 40% is the minimum level of attainment in order to promote from one grade to another grade. So there is a two modality. One modality is that at the end of year you take exam, and those who are securing 40%, you should promote them. So that was the old philosophy. No detention policy. The philosophy of no detention policy says that by the CCE and by identifying their difficulty, by the identifying their strength, you prepare them, you prepare all students for at least 40% of attainment, so that there will be no necessity of conducting year-end examination. because all of them are at least 40% of attainment level. So there is a no necessity of conducting examination. Isn't it? It was also one of the very much problem that those who are student who are doing hard work, they were also not rewarded. So they were demotivated from doing the hard work because they think that whatever the mark you will secure, whatever the performance you will do, there is a no clear cut distinction between the others. So the hard work was not sufficiently rewarded. That's why it was the student who were doing the hard work, they were demotivated. The next thing is that in the name of implementing no detention policy, the all responsibility have been given to the teacher, and the teacher were not competent. Teacher were overburdened, overloaded because of the less number of teachers in the school, less human resources in the school. So the condition of a teacher become pathetic. Even since the student were not detained, they have been not evaluated and examined, and the CCE was not implemented in its full essence. So the adequate level of a competency was not developed in the student. That resulted the unclear future of the student because they don't know, isn't it? Then the value of academic outcome was also in the question because the student were not graded in the manner of their achievement in the class. So that was the drawbacks also. Then point comes that what we can do. There was several modality to come up with this. One modality was that we can strengthen the CCE, we can improve the teacher strength in the school, and we can sensitize the community. But the thing is, community sensitization is not a one day phenomenon. In the name of improving the teacher strength, majority of the state have recruited teachers on a non permanent basis. Somewhere they were named as a Sikhya Sahayak, somewhere they are named as a Sikhya Mitra, somewhere they are named as a para teacher, who were not given a respectable salary for their work. And when they will not, you will not get a respectable and justified wages for your work, then your motivation to do that work will be affected. So that didn't work. And ultimately, you must know that now the education policy that we have, it had scrapped out, even before that, government have scrapped out the no detention policy because it was based on an assumption which was not attainable for the government. Even before that, you know that there was one draft education policy 2019, which is also known as a Subramaniam committee because it was developed under the chairmanship of TSS Subramaniam. Subramaniam committee also recommended that no detention policy should be scrapped out, and the new education policy 2020 also says that it must be scrapped out. Because it was based on an assumption which was not attainable.